हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द मैक्सिमम टॉपिक दैट इज अरिथमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन। इन दिस वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द टर्म सीक्वेंस, टर्म इन सीक्वेंस, अरिथमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन एंड हाउ टू फाइंड द एंथ टर्म ऑफ एन एपी दैट इज द फॉर्मूला टी एन इज इक्वल्स टू ए प्लस एन माइनस वन डी। फर्स्ट वी स्टार्ट विद द टॉपिक सीक्वेंस। वॉट इज मीन्ड बाय सीक्वेंस? अ सीक्वेंस इज अ कलेक्शन ऑफ नंबर्स which are arranged in definite order according to the definite rule. For example, here I take some examples. Set of natural numbers, set of squares of natural numbers, and one more example. If you observe these three examples, in these three examples we see some relationship between two consecutive terms. For example, in first 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on, if we add 1 in each term, we got next term. For example, if add plus 1, we got 2. Then if we add 1 in second term, we got third term. Here also in second example, 1 square is 1, then 2 square is 4, 3 square is 9 and 4 square is 16. In third example, if we add 6 in each term, we got next term. Means in these three examples, we see there is some relationship between the two consecutive terms. Now our next topic is arithmetic progression. What is meant by arithmetic progression? Arithmetic progression means in a sequence the difference between two consecutive terms is constant. That sequence is called arithmetic progression. For example, here I take example 5, 10, 15, 20 and so on. Here we see t1 is 5, t2 is 10, then t3 is 15 and t4 is 20 and so on. Here we find the difference between two consecutive terms. For example, here t2 minus t1, 10 minus 5 is 5. Here t3 minus t2 is equals to 15 minus 10 is equals to 5. Then t4 is equals to minus t3 is equals to 20 minus 15, 5. In this, the difference between two consecutive terms is constant, that is 5. Therefore, this sequence is an example of arithmetic progression, and in short, we call it as AP. And in AP, in arithmetic progression, first term is generally denoted by small a, and here the first term is given 5, and the common difference is denoted by small d, and common difference is 5. Now we take some example of arithmetic progression. Here the first example is 2, 4, 6, 8, and next example is 0.3, 0.33, then 0.333 and 0.3333 and so on. Here which of the following sequence is an AP? Here the question is which of the following sequence is an AP. Here first sequence 2, 4, 6 and 8 means term 1, t1 is here 2, t2 is 4, t3 is 6, t4 is 8 and so on. Here in arithmetic progression, first of all find the difference between the two consecutive terms. Here t2 minus t1 is equals to 4 minus 2. The difference in these two terms is 2. Then t3 minus t2 is equals to 6 minus 4, 2, and t4 minus t3 is equals to 8 minus 6 is equals to 2. In these terms, the difference between the consecutive terms is constant, 2, 2 and 2. Therefore, the given sequence is an AP. This is an example of arithmetic progression. In second example, here t1 is 0.3, t2 is 0.33, t3 is 0.333 and t4 is 0.333 and so on. Here difference between the two consecutive terms 0.33 minus 0.3, the difference between these two term is 0.03. In next two terms, the difference between these 0.333 minus 0.3 3 is 0.003, and in this the difference between these two number is 0.000 and 3. Means in this example the difference between the two consecutive terms is not constant, that's why the given sequence is not an example or is not an AP. Now here we take one example, write an AP whose first term is A and common difference is D. Here one example is given, A is equals to 10 and common difference D is equals to 5. Here first term A, T1 is equals to 10. Then we find second term, write T1 and add difference, that is 10 plus 5 is equals to 15. For finding third term, T2 plus D, 15 plus 5 is equals to 20. For fourth term, T3 plus D, 20 plus 5 is equals to 25, and so on. Therefore, here the required AP is first term 10, T2 is 15, then third term is 20, 25, and so on. Here in second example, first term means A is given minus 3 and B is 0. A is equals to T1 is equals to minus 3. For finding second term T2, T1 plus B, that is common difference. Here T1 is minus 3 plus common difference B is given 0. Therefore, by calculating the answer is minus 3. Then for third term, T2 plus D, that is minus 3 plus 0, again minus 3. For fourth term, T3 plus B, minus 3 plus 0 is equals to minus 3, and so on. Here the required AP is minus 3, minus 3, minus 3, minus 3, and so on. Means from given equation, from given example, in this example first term A, first term is given and common difference is given, and we find the AP, means arithmetic progression. Here also we do same step. Now our next topic is how to find the nth term of an AP by using the formula Tn is equals to A plus n minus 1 B. Here we take some example. Example number 1, find the 19th term of an AP. Here arithmetic progression AP is given 7, 13, 19, 25, and so on. Here first term is 7 and the difference between two consecutive terms, that is 13 minus 7 is 6. By using the formula we have to find here 19th term of this AP. Formula is Tn is equals to A plus n minus 1 B. Here we have to find 19th term, that's why you write T19 is equals to, first term is given A, in the place of n we find 19th term, that's why you write in the place of n 19 minus 1 multiply common difference B is 6. Then by calculating here 7 minus of these two term is 18, multiply 6 write as it is, then again 7 write as it is, multiplication of these two term is 108, 18 multiply by 6 is 108, and addition of these is 115. Means the 19th term of this given AP is 115. In next example, how many two-digit numbers are divisible by 4? Here the question is, how many two-digit numbers are divisible by 4? The two-digit number divisible by 4 are 12, then 16, 20, 24, and last term is 96. Here T1 is 12. T1 means A is equals to T1 is equals to 12, and the difference between these two terms, 16 minus 12, is 4. By using the formula, Tn is equals to A plus n minus 1 b. Here Tn means last term of this AP, it is 96. A is 12, n is not given, because here the question is how many terms or how many numbers are divisible by 4. That's why you write n as it is 1 and the difference is 4. Here 96, by shifting the value of 12, it is in minus, then multiply by 4 to this bracket, it is 4n, then 4. By calculation, the minus of this 84, 4n minus 4 as it is, then by shifting minus 4, it is 84 plus 4, the answer is, addition of these two numbers is 88. By shifting these 4 in our right hand side, n is equals to 88 upon 4, the answer is 22. Means the value of n is 22. Therefore, there are 22 two-digit numbers divisible by 4. I hope you all are understood this today's topic. Thank you so much for watching this video.